Hi and welcome. My name is Daniel Rimmelswan, and with this How Do I video, I will show you how you can handle the data migration when you need to upgrade your app for Dynamics 365 Business Central. At the end of this video, you will know how to include an upgrade code unit in your app, which handles this data migration. I assume that you are already familiar with how to create an app. If you are not familiar with this, please watch the video, How Do I Build My First Extension? I will talk about this in three easy steps. First, I'll explain what I actually mean with upgrading an app. Next, I'll show you the building blocks that you need to use to manage the data migration between versions of your app by showing the upgrade code unit in step two and the module info API in step three. Let's dive into step one right away. In the lifecycle of software, you usually have multiple versions, basically multiple consecutive releases that you want to deploy to your customers. In terms of Dynamics 365, this means you want to publish a new version of your app to customers that already have it. Now, it is very common that a new version of your software has changes to the database schema. You might have added or changed tables, or added, moved, or changed fields, or even more complex, you might have split one table into multiple tables, or vice versa. In most of these cases, the data needs to be handled. You need to describe how the data is going to be moved to the different tables and fields in your app. This is done by code in your app, in a special kind of code unit, an upgrade code unit. Now, do know that this is only necessary when you actually change the schema. When those changes on database level were made, no data needs to be migrated, so no action is needed. The mechanism will automatically restore your data. The purpose of this video is to show you how you can actually handle such a data migration. It all starts by creating a new code unit of the subtype upgrade, which is going to be part of the new version of your app. The subtype upgrade makes it a special kind of code unit with its own special triggers that will be executed at certain events during the upgrade process. All of these triggers are either in a per company context or a per database context. Uncheck preconditions is the first trigger that will be executed, all at the beginning of the upgrade process. Here you can check the state of the app and raise errors when necessary, which will block any further execution of the upgrade. Next, the actual upgrade code should be executed, which you can write in the onUpgrade triggers. If you would like to check the upgrade if all was successful, you can use the onValidate triggers, which will be executed all at the end. Let me show you how this works in practice. As you can see in the manifest, this is version 1 of our bookshelf app. In this app, we've added a book table, a book card page, and a book list page. Let's publish this app and see what it does. The app opens with a book list, and as you can see, there are two records already inserted. When you look for extension management, you can see that the app has been installed and published, and our bookshelf app is here with version 1. We are now in version 2 of the bookshelf app. We extended the customer table with a new field called favorite book number. During the upgrade process, I would like to introduce some logic to fill in this new field with default data. For this purpose, I've created an upgrade code unit. I will use onUpgrade per company, which is a trigger, to first check if the book default already exists, and if it doesn't, we'll create it. Next, I'll update all customers that don't have a favorite book yet with the default book. And finally, I use onValidate per company to check if all went well. All customers should have a value in the new favorite book number. Note that I'm using the per company context, as the customer table is a per company table. I basically want to execute this upgrade logic for the customers in all companies. Upgrading the app itself can be done with PowerShell in these steps on the screen. I'm using variables for parameters that are used more than once. Let's look at the result of this upgrade process. When I look in Extension Management, I can see that version 2 of the Bookshelf app has been installed, so it looks like our upgrade logic has worked. Let's take a look at the book list. The default book has been added, and when I take a look at a customer card, we should see the default book as the new favorite book. And it does. There we have it. The upgrade logic works. During the upgrade, you might need some more information about the app, and maybe about dependent apps that might have been installed alongside the app that you are trying to upgrade. This information might be necessary to give you the right context in order to know exactly what upgrade logic should be executed. For this, Microsoft introduced the ModuleInfo API, which gives you information about the base and apps from within AL. We can get information about the execution context and information on the module. We can have three execution contexts: normal, install, and upgrade. You can use this anywhere in your app, also outside an upgrade code unit, just to be sure your code is only executed in the right context. You can check the execution context either in general or for your own module or even a specific module. The execution context is not the only thing you might want to know. Other information can also be important, like the version of the app or the version of the data that is currently in the system, what are the dependencies, and so on. You can easily create a new module info variable and fill it by calling the navapp.getCurrentModuleInfo statement. It will give you the necessary information about the module that implemented that code, the current module. You can also get information about a specific installed module by using the getModuleInfo method. You will need the app's GUID to specify the module you need information about. For example, it is very useful to figure out the data version of any app you might depend on. Just imagine the new version of your app depends on a certain new version of another app. You might want to check this. Let me show you an example. You could use the onCheck preconditions trigger in the upgrade code unit to check the major version of another app and raise an error if this app wasn't upgraded to a certain version that you depend on. In this example, it would give an error if this specific app wasn't upgraded to at least version 3. This concludes this introduction in how you can take care of the data during upgrading to new versions of your app. I showed you three steps. First, I explained what I mean with upgrading. Second, I showed you the fundamental part, the upgrade code units. And finally, I talked about how you can extend a bit more by giving the upgrade logic more context by using the ModuleInfo API that comes with AL. For more information, please follow the link on your screen. Thank you for watching this video, and have a nice day.